Hello， 大家好，我是丸子 Tina。 今天这个视频呢，是一个本频道的经典栏目，就是雅思口语示范。那今天讲的话题呢，是雅思9到12月份口语题库当中的一个比较难的题目。我很多的雅思口语班的同学们都说不知道该怎么样下手。这道题呢，是一个 Part 2的题目。他说 Describe a time you were friendly to someone you didn't like. You should say when and where it happened, who he or she was, why you didn't like this person, and explain why you were friendly to him or her on that occasion. 这道题目难呢，难在首先第一个，它让我们去 recall some unpleasant experience. But our human brain is wired to remember only the good ones. 所以要想一个不好的经历确实是挺难的，就是素材方面你要自己去找一下了。第二点呢，是这道题其实它有三个巧妙的地方我们要注意的。第一个是 It's asking you to describe a time or an occasion, not a general thing like, oh, I always say good morning to her, 或者是 I always bring him a cup of coffee in the afternoon. 我们要讲的是一个 isolated incident, 一个独立的事件。第二个巧妙点在于 You need to explain why you didn't like this person first. 虽然这一点在题目当中给的是第三个 bullet point, 可是呢，实际上在我们说话的时候要首先建立起你为什么不喜欢这个人，才有后续的故事，否则来讲呢，逻辑上是很难讲得通的。第三个巧妙之处呢，在于 your dislike of this person should be factual, not prejudice. 你不喜欢他是一个事实，而不是说哦，我之前误解他了，然后我现在知道他不是这样的为人，我就开始 be friendly 去喜欢他了。不是的，你还是不喜欢他，只不过在那一个独立事件当中 you choose to be friendly. 所以呢，我们在准备的时候一定要注意到这三个巧妙的地方，才能帮助你有一个更加好的 performance. 我们知道雅思口语考试其中一个项目就叫做 fluency and coherence. Coherence 这边指的就是你的回答是否逻辑，是否 logical， 你的answers 是否回应到题目了，所以大家一定要注意了。那接下来呢，我就会用我自己的亲身经历进行一些改编来做一个简短的示范。 All right, so I used to have a colleague in my department who was quite obnoxious. I really hate to use the word obnoxious to describe her, but I genuinely couldn't think of another word for someone like her who wouldDeliberately spread complete falsehood about me at work and still smiled at me as if nothing had happened. And surprisingly, it was my supervisor, the vice principal, who told me about what she did. And I was really grateful that he did look into things and found she was lying. Anyways, since I knew she was such a hypocrite, I tried to avoid any contact with her if I could, so as to minimize my emotional damage.But once we were having a department meeting and I arrived a bit early, she was there already. So there were only the two of us in the meeting room. I couldn't help noticing that she looked a bit pale. She was propping her head with one hand and she looked as if she could melt into the conference table the next second. So out of courtesy, I asked her if she was feeling all right. And turned out she did have a bit of pain in her stomach.And I happened to have some general painkillers, you know, Panadol, at my desk. So I asked her if she would like to have some, and she said it would be nice. So I went back to my office to fetch the medicine and also brought a cup of warm water for her to swallow down the pills. And to be honest, I was still very upset about what she did to me. But it was just that at that moment, I felt it was the right thing to do to take care of a colleague who was clearly suffering.I did have grudges, but it's just that I think I shouldn't let my grudge fester and turn me into a senseless being. Having said that, I am not a saint. I don't have impeccable moral standards. But I think when I do have a choice, I would remind myself to choose kindness over other conflicting values.好了，刚刚呢就是我的一个不太完美的示范了，但是大家可以看到大致的逻辑结构是从你为什么不喜欢他开始讲起，这是你这个话题的一个基础，再讲到那一个独立事件，在那个事件当中你是怎么做的，然后最后呢讲到你为什么会这样做，你的一个缘由。如果大家还有时间剩的话呢，可以讲到 in the future 你会怎么样做，如果你在未来遇到同样的事件同样的人你还会怎么样做，就是帮我们去 拓展这个话题和满足一个时间要求的。那除了这个部分之外呢，在 Part 3也有一道题目是让很多同学感觉到没有头绪的。这道题目问的是 What are the differences between being polite and being friendly?这道题目的难处呢，在于它是一个比较题。雅思当中，凡是比较题都是很小心，要很小心去回答的，因为两个比较项目你都要去讲到。第二个难点呢，在于它是一个抽象题目，我们要比较两组 concepts， 一组 concepts 就是 friendliness 和 politeness。那以下呢是我的一个简短的示范。I think most of the time, friendliness and politeness may overlap.But if you think about it further, being friendly and being polite are two different things. You can be friendly without being polite and vice versa. For example, when a bunch of boys are playing, they may use vulgar language to address each other. They may make very mean jokes, but deep down they're still very friendly. And their way of showing friendliness is to show that, oh, I can make jokes about you without fearing that you'll be offended.But in another situation, say when a couple is arguing, they may still use very polite language, right? Like please, thank you, would you please to talk to each other. But then they say it in a very passive aggressive way. So they may sound polite, but they're not friendly. So I guess that's the difference.好，来分析一下我刚刚这个讲话逻辑。刚刚呢是一个及时的一个回复哈。那但是呢我在讲的时候我还是很尝试的去把这两组概念分清楚，就是 politeness 跟 friendliness 它其实未必是两个一定是相关的概念。多数情况之下我们会说他们俩是差不多的哈，但是还是有情况是说你 polite 未必代表你 friendly， 然后你 friendly 呢也未必代表你 polite， 这个 vice versa 这个 phrase 表示反之亦然，就不用再很啰嗦的去讲、哦、怎么样了 ，OK？ 那我在讲的时候呢，会有给到例子，比如说第一个例子是讲一群男孩，他们可能会对对方说粗口啊之类的，但是他们还是很 friendly 友善的。但是呢，如果是大家在吵架的时候，可能你会说啊，请你不要这样子的话语。虽然你很生气，你很想去抵触，可是呢，你是用一种抑制的感觉 ，passive 的感觉来去抵触这个东西，叫做 passive aggressive。那这个时候你虽然是很 polite， 可是你就不是 friendly。所以用两个例子。例子去解释一个比较复杂的概念性的问题，我觉得也是大家可以去尝试的。好了，那以上呢就是我对九到十二月份的这一道难题的一个简短的解析了，希望对各位正在备考的同学们有所帮助。那希望大家喜欢这个视频，我们就下次再见吧，拜拜。